Today we are going to discuss about index and snapshot lifecycle management. So index lifecycle management, a very popular, you know, topic or more much discussed topic in the Elasticsearch world. And because of the huge amounts of data that Elasticsearch takes in and the amount of management that is being done on top of the data that is stored in Elasticsearch indices. So index lifecycle management is kind of a cron. I wouldn't say that it is a simple cron-like scheduler, but then it is a very easy and it has also a UI. It has also an API through which you can schedule these policies onto an indices and move the data off to your different hardware to a different sort of a hardware template, which helps you to save costs, which helps you manage the data, remove the stale indices, etc. So there are four phases in index lifecycle management. I'll also come to explain you how these policies or the concepts can be applied onto the data that is stored in Elasticsearch index. So there are four phases. One is like hot, which is a required phase, and then like you also have warm, cold, and the heat phases. So each index, you can enable these. Of course, you have to like take this hot node and hot phase and like put it on a specific node attribute. Also, otherwise, like you could use, if you're using a cloud service, like Elasticsearch service, you could simply go and deploy these hot tier, warm tier, and cold tier, and then thereby you could apply these hardware profiles easily. Once you have that cluster built up with certain hardware profiles, the nodes which are designated as hot, warm, and cold, or like which has hot and warm tiers, then you could simply go to the index lifecycle management and do all of this. So each phase has a specific amount, specific actions, and these actions are the ones that helps you to do the necessary management in the index. Say, for example, in a hot phase, you just want to shrink the data before it is going to warm phase. Like say hot phase is most actively queried data, written data, and then you want to move to warm phase where the data is not so much queried, but then like you have some querying happening, but you don't write data more. So if you want to reduce the number of primary shards, then you might use a shrink. Or if you want to do some other migration or take a snapshot out of the how hot cluster and put it in a S3 kind of a feature, like we discussed searchable snapshot yesterday, so which helps you to do all of that. So that those are the things that the index lifecycle management helps you to do that. Now quickly I'll get to the demo part and then show you how you can do all of this pretty much easily. So say for it, I have this entire the script here in the GitHub disk as a GitHub disk, so please use that. If I'm not able to cover everything, etc., like you could always refer this and create it on your own. So I have this ILM policy wherein specifically I want to create this ILM policy with the max age as 2 minutes and max size as 2 KB, because the session is short. I want to reduce it to such level that we could see that in see the ILM in action. So I will just create this policy. This policy has already been created, but I just want to recreate or reset it again. And then you could see the index lifecycle policy is set. Now this policy will go under a index template. The this topic again is discussed in the daily Elastic Byte, but you also have the index template contains the index settings, aliases or mappings, as well as part of the settings, you will find this ILM policy. So if you see here, I have this index template and it contains all these things, but I could go to the index management also, and then go to the index templates and apply that particular part. Say for example, or else I could also go to the index lifecycle policy. Let us, while we are discussing that, why not do that? So I'm going to go to the action, add to the index template, and say my index template, and then add policy. So I have also discussed data streams in this session. So if you see, if you create a data stream, all these things happen much clearly and easily. Otherwise, you need to set up an alias for rolling over the data and linking it to that specific alias actually. So also the index lifecycle policy, as I said, it's like a scheduler which runs or polls onto the indices for checking whether the conditions are met or not. So this is actually 10 minutes by default. I would make it to because of the session and etc. I would make it to 15 seconds, which is very less. Please don't do it in the production, but then like I'm just trying to show you the feature here. And then I'll create this, you know, now I don't have my index item, a data stream that I want to create. Say I'm just indexing one, two, or three documents. I'll keep the fourth one so that when the index rolls over from one phase to another, you could probably see that. Now we have, say, the other index already got created. You might see more and more indexes because every 15 seconds, it sees the information, and then if it passes that information, it will move over and create another one. Say in a similar manner, I have set the condition as like either it is like, you know, 2 minutes or 2 KB or max docs is 2. So based on that, it creates the data, and I mean, it creates a new index, rolls over the existing index and like creates a new one, and all your writes grow into the new index. So this is how the entire thing works. You could also like kind of check the entire indices or how the ILM works, and through the index ILM explain API, you will see when it has completed, what phase it has completed, what is the current phase of the index, how much time it took. You will also see some details like suppose if a certain number of actions have been failed on a specific index, then it stays, saves it in a specific cache, and then like reloads it when again it is revisiting, if needed, if it has to pick it up from that particular point of time. So there are many things that are there in entire ILM process. I would definitely recommend you to go and check it out, and the full docs actually. Now coming on to the next one, and we have very less time, but I want to cover that as well. So snapshotting from Elasticsearch, like in specifically, you also have a snapshot lifecycle policy. Again, this can be added to you know, the index lifecycle management itself, like index lifecycle management having a snapshot lifecycle policy through which you can, every time when you want to snapshot or do something else, you could do you could put that data into that particular place. So I have a bucket here, and I have set up the bucket related the service account credentials in my Elasticsearch cluster. I mean Elasticsearch details. And I could simply go to the snapshot and restore places. And I have registered this GCP repo, which I have created here. You could also check the verify the status of it. And then I have a policy that I have created, say that every time, every 20th minute, the snapshot should run. And then it should create a snapshot with this specific name, and then delete all these indices that are getting created every 20th minute. Like that means that 24 of those snapshots should be deleted. So these are the things that I have like run, and then like I have created, and then it will fire whenever the things happen. So otherwise you could also click on run now. It will start running the policy and makes things better. So this is the overall idea of like how ILM, SLM works in Crux in 8 minutes. Thanks for attending. And if you have any questions, I'm happy to answer.